Hey guys, I'm Nisha Homi and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing a very healthy and tasty cake made with jaggery and ragi flour. Ragi flour is also known as finger millet. It's a perfect guilt-free cake, especially if you're on a weight loss journey. This cake is made with jaggery and not with refined sugar. Super delicious, super healthy and tasty. See how soft this cake is. And nobody will even guess there is ragi flour in this cake. So without wasting much time, let's get started with the recipe. First, you need to roast the ragi flour. So for that, I have already heated a pan and I'm adding in 1 cup of ragi flour and lightly roast the ragi flour on low to medium flame. Now, while the ragi flour is roasting, make sure you stir it on and off so that the ragi flour does not get burnt. Roasting the ragi flour is highly recommended as it will help to diminish the raw flavor of the ragi flour in the cake. So do not skip this process. And once the ragi flour is roasted, transfer it to another plate and allow it to cool down completely. Into a bowl, I'm adding in 1 cup of ragi flour. Now I'm using a sieve to sieve the flour. Add in 1 cup whole wheat flour. Now I don't use store-bought atta. I buy wheat grain and then wash and sun-dry and then give it to the local mill to powder. Store-bought atta may contain added gluten, so I don't use store-bought atta in my recipes. So this is locally milled whole wheat flour which does not contain any added gluten. Now into this I'm adding in 3 tablespoons cocoa powder, 2 and 3. Now usually the cocoa powder will be having some lumps, so it's always ideal to sieve the cocoa powder along with the rest of the dry ingredients. Add in 1 teaspoon baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda. Now when you use baking soda, make sure you use good quality baking soda. I will leave the link to the baking soda in the description box below this video. And now mix this all well and sieve it into the bowl. This process will make both the wheat flour and the ragi flour fluff, and it will also help to incorporate little bit of air in the flours. So that will eventually help to make the cake softer. And now I'm going to keep this aside. Into another bowl, I'm going to add in the wet ingredients. So I'm adding in 100 grams salted butter. This butter has come to room temperature, which means I kept it outside the fridge for about 15 to 20 minutes. So the butter has softened, and since I'm using salted butter, I won't be adding any extra salt in this cake recipe. If you're using unsalted butter, make sure you add in 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Now I'm using a glass square pan to bake the cake, and what I'm going to do is I'm just greasing the pan with the butter left on the paper with which the butter was wrapped. With this butter wrapped paper, I'm just greasing the whole cake pan. Usually there will be a little bit of butter stick to the butter wrapper, so I make use of it like this. And make sure you grease the sides as well, do not skip that. You can use a round cake pan if you prefer. Today I'm using a square cake pan. So now the cake pan is fully greased and I have placed a butter paper in the cake pan. I'm also leaving some butter paper on both the sides like this. This will actually help to pull out the cake once it is baked. So I prefer to do this way. And now I'm going to keep this aside, and at this point I have already preheated the oven to 180 degrees Celsius. And now I'm just going to lightly mix the butter. As you can see, the butter is already softened. Now instead of butter in this recipe, you can also use virgin coconut oil. Virgin coconut oil has a very neutral taste, so you don't actually feel that coconut flavor in the cake. Now many of you always ask me which coconut oil I use. So this is the virgin coconut oil I use currently. I do sometimes make virgin coconut oil at home. So this is the one which I'm currently using. As you can see, it is clear as water. I bought this from ICAR, Central Plantation Crops Research Institute, Kasaragod. They have a sale counter there, so if you ever pass by this place, you can get organic stuffs like honey, virgin coconut oil, coconut sugar, coconut vinegar and many other things. So this is a pure fresh organic coconut oil which they produce at ICAR Research Institute and made from the coconut trees in the research institute. So it's organic, got a very neutral taste. Into this add in 1 cup jaggery powder. Now instead of jaggery powder you can also use coconut sugar. Since many of you asked me from where I buy my ingredients, I just want to show you the coconut sugar which I have been using recently. So this is the coconut sugar which I have been using and this is the name of the brand. It's 150 rupees for 250 gram. So these are the details. If you are living in Tamil Nadu, you can contact them by phone or you can go to their website or even email them. This is not a sponsored video. I just happened to use this coconut sugar and I kind of liked it since many of you always ask me to share things which I use personally. So this is something which I've been using for some time now. In this recipe you can use coconut sugar if you have or you can use powdered jaggery. Since this is an eggless cake, I'm using 1/2 cup curd. This is home set curd. If you want to use eggs in this recipe, you can use 2 eggs instead of 1/2 cup curd. And now I'm going to give this a mix. Now instead of a whisk, you can also use an egg beater. Using an egg beater is more easier than using a whisk. So I'm just going to mix this really well and make sure that the jaggery is nicely incorporated into the butter and the curd. Sometimes the mixture may curdle like you are seeing now, but it does not matter. Now into this I'm adding in the sifted dry ingredients. I have also measured 1/2 cup milk and I'm going to add the milk little by little. And now with a spatula I'm just folding the dry ingredients. Adding the rest of the dry ingredients, the rest of the milk. Now for this recipe I am using 250 ml measuring cup. I am adding in about 2 tablespoons of extra milk just to make the batter loose. As you can see, the batter is slightly thick. So I'm adding in about 1 to 2 tablespoons of milk. So that's 2 tablespoons of milk. So I've used 1/2 cup plus 2 tablespoons milk in this recipe. Now there is one little thing which I forgot to add in this cake. It should have been added along with the wet ingredients. So I'm adding in 3/4 teaspoon vanilla essence. I'm not going to mix it vigorously, like I'm just folding it into the batter because I don't want the air trapped in the batter to be released out. Now you don't forget to add vanilla essence like I did. Add the vanilla essence along with the curd and milk. Okay, now the batter is ready and as you can see it is a thick creamy batter. So this is the consistency I'm looking for. Pour the batter into the prepared cake pan. And now with the spatula, I'm just leveling the cake batter. My son is preparing for plus two board exams and he's been sitting late at night to study. So I thought I should make something healthy for him so that he gets some extra energy. So I also wanted to make sure that he's snacking healthy. So that is why I thought I'll make this ragi cake today. And now gently tap this a couple of times on the countertop. This will help to release air bubbles if there are any. So I'm going to bake the cake at 180 degrees Celsius for about 25 to 30 minutes. Okay, now the cake is nicely baked. So I'm just going to test it with a skewer. So the cake is nicely baked. And I'm going to allow this to cool down a little bit. And then I'm going to transfer it to a wire rack to allow it to cool completely. I'm running a knife on the sides of the pan. As you can see, I have left some butter paper on the sides. So because of this, it's very easy to pull the cake out of the pan. And place the cake onto a wire rack. And allow the cake to cool down. Let me just show you how soft the cake is. Very soft and very tasty and very healthy. A perfect guilt-free indulgence. So guys, do try this healthy ragi cake and let me know how this turned out. Don't forget to like, comment and share this video with family and friends. And a very happy Republic Day to all of you. Jai Hind.